ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ಸೆಷನ್ 9 ಆಫ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ 2 ಲೇತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಷಿನ್ ಟೂಲ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಕೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ 15ME43T ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಇಮ್ರಾನ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಕ್ಯಾನಿಕಲ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಲಿಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ಕಾರ್ವಾರ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸ್ವಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಲೇತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ multiple spindle automatic lathe. So the Swiss type automatic lathe, so it is a machine, the headstock is movable and tools are fixed. So in earlier machines we have to say that the tools are moving longitudinally, but here the tools are fixed and the headstock is movable. So in that case the headstock, in the earlier automatic lathe, the headstock is only rotating the workpiece but not moving in a longitudinal direction. But in case of Swiss type automatic lathe, the headstock is movable. Headstock is movable and the tools are fixed. Tools are fixed means it will not move in a crosswise direction. It will move in the crosswise direction to give the feed, but it will not move longitudinally. It will not move longitudinally. So longitudinal movement is not fixed in case of lathe, in case of tool in a Swiss type automatic lathe. So this longitudinal movement is accomplished by a headstock. You can see it is by cam and camshaft. You can see as this cam rotates, so you can see it is having an angular direction. If this projection will come here, that means the tailstock will move forward. By this, when the camshaft rotates, it will push the headstock in a longitudinal direction. That will perform the various tool held in cross lights will perform the operation. So it is performed by the rotation of cam, and cam shaft will handle the movement of the headstock. So we have number of tools which are mounted radially towards the workpiece. The cross lights are mounted in a radial direction. So you can see five tools, cross lights and three angular ones. One is perfectly vertical, another two angular cross lights carrying tools will perform the different operation on the same workpiece sequence by sequence. So you can see this tool side is performing two operations here on the workpiece. This is the job, this is the headstock. So this is the headstock is movable, you can see. This is the tool slide radially, that is cross slide. So the third tool, which is mounted on the turret, is performing the drilling operation, you can see. So you can handle more than six tools at a time, or sequence by sequence. The bar stock is held in rotating collet. So this is the bar stock, which is held in the rotating collector. So as usual, the stock feeding mechanism is used to advance the workpiece. After the completion of one workpiece, the same bar stock will advance again for performing second operation. The bar stock is held in rotating collet and in the headstock, and all the longitudinal feeds are obtained by cams. So these cams are used for performing longitudinal feed, which moves the entire headstock as unit. The rotating bar stock is fed through hard bushing in center of the tool head. So this machine are used for machining long parts. So this machine is usually used for long workpieces with a small diameter. The earlier machine is used for larger diameter workpiece, but it is of small length. But here this type of lathes are used for lengthier workpiece, but the diameter is very less, 2 to 25 millimeter. So the tool head consists of 5 single point cutting tools. The tool head consists of 5 single point cutting tools, 2 in the horizontal side like this, and 3, one is exactly vertical and another 2 in a angular direction. Totally the radially 5 tools are acting, and the 6th tool is from turret side. Turret is carrying one tool which performs the boring or maybe tapping operation or drilling operation, etc. So, three slides, mostly the diameter turning is done by 2 horizontal slides opposite direction, and other 3 slides are used for the operations such as knurling, chamfering and cutoff. Tools are controlled and positioned by cams that brings the tool needed to turn the face form cut off workpiece from the bar. It emerges from bushing. Flows torrent of up to 0.005 to 0.00125 mm are obtained. Flows torrents are obtained by this kind of machines. So next is multiple sinter. So the up to this what you have studied, the different types of, it may be caster and turret lathe, or it may be engine lathe, or it may be automatic lathe, single spindle automatic, switch type automatic lathe, are carrying only one headstock spindle. So in case of multiple spindle, we have a set of 2, 4, 5, 6 spindle. You can see here it is having 4 spindle. So each spindle carries a different workpiece. So at a time we can handle more than 4 or 5 workpieces at a time, and all the operation are performed at a time. So there is a large, huge production, and there is a huge production requirement. So that in this case we are using multiple spindle automatic machine. So multiple spindle carries in multiple workpiece, and all the operation are performed at a time. So same operation is performing in the all the workpieces. So it will save the time and increases the production time. So these are faster type of production machine, and are made in variety of models such as 2, 4, 5, 6 spindle in contact with single spindle machine, where one turret face at a time is working on spindle. In multiple spindle machine, all the turret faces work on the spindle at a same time. So production capacity is higher, machining accuracy is lower compared to single spindle. The machining accuracy is lower compared to the single spindle machine because it will concentrate on one workpiece, but here more than 4, 5, 6 are working together. So the accuracy will be somewhat least compared to single spindle machines, because of longer setup time, increased tooling cost, this machine are less economical than other short runs, more economical for longer runs. So this machines is less economical for long runs. That means if you are doing limited components, then this machine is not economical. If you are doing the same component for a long time, if you are producing the same component for a long time, toward the month or toward the year, we are doing the same component, then this machine is suitable for production. So what is the difference here? In case of multiple spindle, more than 2, 4, 6 spindles, headstock spindle that carries a different more than spindle. How many spindles are present in the headstock? That much workpiece we can handle at a time. So all the operations are performed at a time, not the sequence of operation. If the one component is doing one operation, then the second spindle is doing this second operation. So the during indexing, the once operation of this first spindle is completed, that will move to the second tool, so that will perform the second operation. Similarly, in this tool, the next component will come. So that will, the operation is continuous. There is no simply wasting of the machining time. The operation is continuous, one by one. All the operations are performed on the components, and that increases the production. And you can handle more than 5-6 workpieces at a time. That will only the increases the production time. So in this type of machine, the same operation is performed on each spindle. So same operation is performed on the each spindle. The workpiece finished in each spindle in one working cycle. So the workpiece is completed in each working cycle. How it is means, suppose there are 6 spindles. So one in one spindle, the drilling operation will take place. So what will happen, that workpiece, after finishing that operation, that spindle will index, and the second machine will come, the second workpiece will come, that the tool is performing the same operation, a drilling operation in that machine, whereas the second tool is performing maybe a chamfering operation, whatever. So after the completion of this chamfering operation, the tool, the workpiece will move to the third tool, whereas the component workpiece which is in drilling operation will come to the chamfering operation. Similarly, in each cycle, in each one complete cycle, one one workpiece will be fully completed its operation. Similarly, in each cycle, one component will come finishes its workpiece. One output will come on each working cycle. Similarly, for one complete cycle, we are using one output of the workpiece. So it will increase the production time. Obviously, the number of components being machined equals to number of spindles in the machine. How many components are present? How many spindles are present in the spindle? That much components we can handle at a time. Rate of production is high, and machine can be used to machine small parts only. This machine is used for machining very small parts only. These machines are usually automatic. Cutting off of bar type machines is used to perform the same work, or as spindle automatic cut off machines. The machine consists of frame with headstock at right end and horizontal work spindles that are arranged one above the another or housed in the headstock. Cross legs are located at right angle, right and left side of the spindle and carries the feeding tools. All working auxiliary motions of the machines are obtained by cam mounted on the cam shaft. In all automatic machines, cam and cam shafts are used for the longitudinal movement of the both workpiece and the tool. So before going to end this session, we just see the two kinds of single spindle automatic machine and multiple spindle automatic machine. This is a Swiss type automatic machine. You can see here you can see that the tool, the workpiece is moving longitudinally. As I told here, the headstock is movable and the tools are fixed. Here the headstock is moving by the cam and the tools will not move longitudinally. The tools will move only in the crosswise direction. See, this workpiece is moving here. It is possible only in Swiss type of machine. So this is about Swiss type machine. Just now you see the multiple spindle automatic machine. So this is the multiple spindle automatic machine. You see, symbols here, 1, 2, 3, 4. These symbols are there, more than one symbol. Like that time. Here in this video we come to know the multiple SCO, sequence of operation. For one complete cycle, one output is obtained. So this is the headstock. There is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spindles are there. So after the completion of one operation, it will move index it to the next tool here. It will automatically collect the workpiece. After the one operation will be completed, the indexing will happen in spindles, so that next operation will be performed by the tool. Same operation is repeated by the tool. Only thing is that the workpiece has to be changed by indexing. Every time the tool is doing the same operation, but the workpiece will change by indexing continuously. So for one complete rotation of the spindle, that means 6 rotation are there. So for fully 6 rotation, 6 time indexing, one output will be obtained. One output of the workpiece is obtained. So this is about the multiple spindle automatic place. Thank you. Thank you for watching.